light. You're going to make it. And that's what every mama, every daddy, everybody up in here ought to be there for somebody else. But no, God's going to be somebody in your life that's going to, amen, going to upset you. But no, that's part of the plan. They're going to upset you and cause you to lose your patience. But you got to be patient with them because somebody was patient with you. And you got to hang in there and pray for them and uphold them and lift them up because God is working on them. And we are not standing in an hour-on-hour time schedule, but we are depending on God. We're saying, God, you know the time. You know the ending from the beginning, and you can touch them, and you can move them, and you can do the mighty things that I cannot do. So, Lord, I'm not going to wait. And I'm going to wait on you. I'm not going to rely on my own strength and my own intellect, but I'm going to depend on you that you're going to help them just like you helped me. I'm going to all be blessed in the name of the Lord. Somebody shout yes up in here. So Paul, he had a mentality that even I'm going to build up. And I like the way somebody said in Orlando just a few days ago. He said, now, preacher boys, they said, now, you got to realize that, amen, if you are preaching and nobody is getting it, you are unsuccessful with your ministry. You are ministering to people that people can be blessed. Somebody shout yes up in here. And so God has called you for such a time as this that you can be a blessing to somebody, even when it don't look like they're being blessed. You know, somebody you can help and they'll cuss you out.
Yes, sir.
Well,
yeah.
But how many know they did it to Jesus? Yes, so you are not better than your Lord. So why do you think you all that in the back of chips? If they did it to the Lord Jesus, God Almighty, they'll do it to you. Yes, but you can be of good cheer because if they done it to him and then they'll do it to you, and God is saying, well, praise be unto God, if you suffer with me, you're going to reign. Gonna reign with me. Let me know. God didn't call us here for a flowery bed of ease. Amen. The devil's gonna be upset at you all of the way, and you just gotta make up your mind that I'm gonna stick with the script. I'm gonna stay with the plan that God has for my life, and I'm gonna be there for my loved ones. I'm gonna be there for my coworkers. I'm gonna be there for my neighbors. I'm gonna be there for whoever God brings in my life, because God to be a blessing, and I am not going to fall for the enemy's tactics and the mindset with the crab mentality. When somebody else succeeds, I get all jacked up and jealous and all envious of them. I want you to succeed. I want you to have something more than what I have, because I know if God bless you, God will bless me. And so I don't have time to get all uptight. I don't have time to be jealous and envious of you. I want you to be blessed.
Amen.
That's what a lot of folk problems is. They're jealous of somebody else. That's what happened on my job, you know. They don't want to tell somebody that's younger secrets or information on the equipment, on the job assignment. They want you to be ignorant because they don't want you to avail, because if they know everything and have everything, that's going to make them look like they're somebody special. But I want you to know that you need to pour into somebody. And when you pour into them, God will begin to fill your cup up. And you'll be like David. Amen. He will fill your cup till it overflows. I got to hurry up with this, but I want you to know that the Apostle Paul knew his assignment. He knew his purpose, and that was to be there for somebody. Somebody need to hear me up in here. God called you not to be a man pleaser, but he called you to be a people person, that you be there to love folk and help folk, because somebody down in the valley trying to get home, somebody been way off for a long time, and they're tired, and they're not giving you all of the signals that they're tired. But as I told, amen, some preachers, amen, when I preached on, amen, Thursday night, I told them that we got a lot of phonies in church. We got a lot of folk come up in here with a nice suit of clothes on, got a nice pretty dress on, got your makeup all together, got your hair do all together, but on the inside, you are all messed up. What you really need to do is say, Lord, I stretch my hands to you. No other help I know. If you withdrew yourself from me, where would I go? No, I can't fool you. You know my heart. Hallelujah. Don't be no phony. Be real with the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. And every now and then, you need to get you a prayer partner. Every now and then, you need to hook up with somebody, because God has blessed us through humanity, and it's not going to all drop out of the sky. It's not going to always just drop in your spirit, but God will send somebody your way to be a blessing in your life, because as the brethren know, iron sharpens iron. One brother can lift up another brother's countenance, and sister, that goes for you. You can have sisterhood. You need to have sisterhood and lift up your sisters. And then even if they don't like you, you gotta love them in spite of their dislike. I love you even though you don't like me, even though you don't wanna hang with me. That's all right. I love you anyway, because I can pray for you when I'm in my secret closet. I can lift you up before God. Hallelujah. He'll do it. Somebody shout, he'll do it. Hell on here, but I want you to know God, amen, wants us to know something from this particular text, because Apostle Paul was writing to the church of Philippi, and according to theologian, it was the first church in Europe, amen, that was established. And Apostle Paul established this church on his second missionary journey. And the church of Philippi was special to Paul's heart. And so Paul was encouraging them in the Lord. And there were some things that he wanted them to know, because he said, now I'm going to stand before God one day, and I want my running not to be in pain. I don't want my labor to be in pain. So I want you to do, and then what God has called me to share with you to do. And if you do that, there'll be some praise before God if you do. And then what I have instructed you to do, then everybody will be blessed. And then God told me there was a threefold plan, a threefold purpose from this text that he want me to drop in your spirit today. And the three things are, and I'll elaborate just a little bit, and that was that you and I, we got to know our purpose, and that is, number one, we got to set the tone. Everybody shout, set the tone.
Set the tone.
Number two, everybody got to realize your purpose is to bear the light. Everybody shout, bear the light.
Bear the light.
And the third thing that he said for this, that everybody needs to realize that you need to hold tight. Somebody shout, hold tight. Now you got to set the tone. Verse number 14, it says, do all things without murmuring and complaining. I want you to understand today that verse is saying that you and I, as believers of Jesus Christ, we've got to have the right attitude and the right demeanor, and then that we have before the world. And then our problem is we make the wrong folk upset and make the devil glad.
I gotta
break that down. We make the wrong folk upset and we make the devil glad. What are you trying to say, brother preacher, is that, amen, that we get all in a frenzy and we argue with one another. And when you're arguing and you're fussing and you're fighting because you disagree, everybody's bumping heads. Guess what's happening? Amen. That brother or that sister that you discouraged right then by all of your temperament and all of your, amen, your confusion has called you to drop the ball.
Yes, sir.
To drop, amen, the baton. And you know who's happy? The devil is happy. See, you can't accomplish anything if you're at odds.
Yes.
You can't accomplish anything if you can't be in agreement. How can two walk together except they agree? And somebody got to be the bigger man, or somebody got to be the bigger woman and say, well, I'm going to, amen, let you have this thing. I'm not going to bump head. I'm just going to pray.
Yeah.
Somebody shout pray.
Pray.
Everybody got their own opinion. Everybody want to have it their way. But how many know, in order for us to do what we need to do, we've got to come together. Somebody shout, come together. Brothers and sisters, we got to come together. The only person that's really, really happy and high-fiving is the devil, because he knows that he is in that one that will cause confusion and division amongst us. And we can't win the world for Jesus Christ if we all divide. murmuring. Stop all that disputing amongst yourself. And remember your purpose is, amen, you got to set the tone. Amen, because God has called you for such a time as this. Let's not take too long. I want to go to the next point. We got to learn to bear the light. The Bible says in Proverbs 4:18 that the path of the just is as a shining light that shineth more and more unto the perfect day. Amen. You and I, amen, must let our light shine, because the Bible said we're in the midst of a perverse and crooked nation, or crooked generation. We got a dark world out there. We got a whole lot of crazy folk out of there, and we got a whole lot of folk really, really, really causing hell out there. I know every now and then, because of our flesh and our mindset, a little hell get on us. But I want you to understand, we got a lot of folk in darkness out there in the world that's, amen, living like hell, and they're going to die and go to hell. And what you and I got to do is, we got to bear the light. We got to call the light of Jesus Christ in every crooked place, in every dark place. We got to let our light shine. We got to let it shine on the mountaintop. We got to let it shine in the valley low. We got to let it shine wherever we go. Let your light shine. Don't put it in the bushel. Don't hide your light. But you go out there and be a light bearer for Jesus Christ. You can't do it sitting in your house all the time. You can't sit. You can't let it do it while you're twiddling your thumb, while you're complaining. You got to get up out of here. You got to be a light for Jesus. And light wants the best when it's in a dark place. Somebody shout yes. So on your job and in your community and wherever you go, let your light shine. Let it shine. Let God be satisfied. Let it shine. And let the enemy be upset. But somebody needs to see the light of Jesus in your life. Thirdly, you got to hold tight. Paul was saying, while you're setting the tone and while you are letting the light shine bright, notice what the Bible says here. It tells us that we got to hold forth the word of life, that I might rejoice in the day of Christ. In other words, you got to hold on, amen, to the life, amen, to the word of God. You got to hold tight and not let go. In other words, you got to stand on the word. You got to stand in the midst of confusion. Stand, bear the light, and hold it tight with the word of God, because that's the only thing that's going to save anybody. It's the word of God. And what the enemy wants you to do is give up on the word. But you got to keep the word in your heart. You got to declare the word, because the Bible says that heaven and earth will pass away, but the word will stand forevermore. Hold tight. The enemy wants to steal your testimony. He wants to steal your joy. He wants to steal the word that God has placed in your bosom. But the devil is a liar. The word that you have, and then will put the devil to flight. It is written in the word of God. It's in the word. And Paul says, if you set the